Hi makers, welcome back to YouMakeTech. In today's episode, I take a look at the HeroMi Gen 5 cooling mode for 3D printers. The HeroMi Gen 5 is a very popular cooling upgrade on Thingiverse, designed by Andrew Soderberg, alias mediaman. In this video, I concentrate my testing on the HeroMi Gen 5 with dual 5015 fans and dual ducts. I am particularly interested in this version because I expect the two fans to provide plenty of airflow. Also, because the two fans are located symmetrically around the nozzle, I expect the airflow to be very balanced. I added in the description of the video the list of parts I printed for the HeroMi Gen 5 version I am testing today. I printed all these parts with 2mm walls, 50% infill, and supports from the ground plate only. In addition to the 3D printed parts, I bought two 24V 5015 fans on Amazon and connected them in parallel. Okay, enough talking. Let's install the HeroMi Gen 5 on the Ender 3 Pro.
Oh,
YouMakeTech Gen 5 gantry adapter shifts the hot-end position forward by about 8 mm, making it incompatible with the Creality Direct Drive and the Speed Drive V1. In order to be able to install the Creality Direct Drive, I printed a modified mount that is 8 mm higher than the original. With the modified mount, the output of the extruder is aligned vertically with the hot end. Adjust the duct height. That's it for the installation. Let's now take a look at the airflow and the noise. The YouMakeTech Gen 5 is very powerful in terms of airflow. It is so powerful that it can even provide too much airflow and must be throttled down. During my testing, I printed parts at 100% fan speed. But notice that the airflow was so strong and so turbulent that it actually deflected the extruding filament. I did some additional testing by lowering the fan speed to 75% or even 50%. And got much better results. Not only the airflow was less turbulent and more balanced, but there was still more than enough cooling, and the noise level was significantly reduced. Now let's compare the print quality between the Ender 3 Pro stop cooling and the YouMakeTech Gen 5 using the cooling fan torture test from TeachingTech. Finally, we put the YouMakeTech Gen 5 to the test by printing an insane 240 mm bridge. This is a simple formality for the YouMakeTech Gen 5. Despite being more complicated to install than other cooling modes, the YouMakeTech Gen 5 performance is amazing. In my testing, the airflow was so strong that I had to throttle it down. The YouMakeTech Gen 5 dual fan version is probably a bit overkill, but it can accommodate any cooling need you have. That's it for today. Thanks for watching and see you soon on YouMakeTech.